Let's learn how to perform administration tasks. This is a theory concepts which is related to the administrative task, where I'll be going to cover different things. Let's say first administration task. First is define data access in model. Basically, whenever we create any models, so who can access that particular model? Who can see what level of details can, that can be assigned on the model? What are the model privacy set when the it is created? It needs to be have the role include data access levels as well. So this is important to set the privacy of any models, because there may be model different models which you may not be wanted to see some different users. So in the business, it can be possible there are different types of users, and their data access level should be different. So in that perspective, we need to set our privacy for the models. So that can be done from this privacy settings for that particular model, where if it is on, then we can see or can give different accesses as this. Then read write per property in dimension. It can apply to all models that use this dimension. One model can have more than one data access control enabled dimension. Access defined in the on a hierarchy node will be propagated to its descendant, but will be overwritten if another access is defined on a lower level node. It can write include read access, write control of the publication, and write access is only for planning. Access management. This is one screenshot. It shows how to do the access management and how the data is shown in the report. You can see what is the read write permission. So for these particular dimensions or measures, there is some who can read. So these are some of the users name given. Those only can see. Otherwise, they cannot see it in the report, and they don't have any write permission as well. So this can be specified for this. Users, and you can see how this report data can be is shown here, which is just a read. It cannot be edited kind of mode. Model based privacy settings as well. We can assign filters to be defined on any property of the dimension in the model. Whenever we create any dimension, you can see here there is an option where it can specify the filters for that particular dimension. There are different permissions which we need to consider: full access, read access, update access, delete access, new documents, new folder. Full access means it they can do everything. Read access, they can just read it. Update means they can update the model. Delete means they can delete the model. New documents means they can create new documents or new folders as well. They are able to create. So these are options available where it can. You can see here if they are checked, then that means they have the access. Or the rest, if you don't want to give the access, then it can be not. The next one is teams in SSE. So in team is a group of users. So a user can belong to multiple teams. If a role is assigned to a team, then all members of the team can inherit that role. Each team has a team folder which can only be accessed by the users in that team. So team is very important. There may be if you create one team which is of same kind of users, suppose there are 10 users who need same kind of access, then we can create a team of that particular 10 users and then assign access to that particular team only, so that all the accesses which has given to that team, that will be inherited to the users in that team. So this is very useful. So better to create a team whenever for the common types of users. How to create team? There is a security and then teams, and once the teams screen is open, there is an option to create a team here, and then we can create team, and then we can add members from here, where we can search for different members and can add it here. What are the best practices for assigning roles to teams? We can assign users to teams, we can assign roles to teams as well. So this is important. When we assign users to teams and assign roles to teams, that means what are the roles which is assigned to that particular team, that will be assigned to that particular users in that particular team. So this is useful to manage or maintain later when we wanted to add or remove any of the users from a particular team. That would be useful to do that. What are the content deployment guidelines? When we deploy anything means from one model, we wanted to deploy to other systems, then what are the guidelines? So SAP Analytics Cloud supports easy export and import of content to and from file. Means it is a very easy export. We don't need to be writing any code for deployment. It's just easy things. If there are dependencies between the content, the dependent content is automatically selected unless it is a location dimension. If you have your enrichment in your model, basically what are the dependencies? It can be automatically selected. Point of interest data is not exported. Point of interest is another component in the SSE which is not exported. Only public content can be exported. You cannot import old exports into newer tenants. So this is important to understand, about the old versions and the new versions. Content deployment, when we do content, it's just a simple deployment option is there in the menu of the SAP Analytics Cloud and export. We can export, then we can decide what type of things which we need to export. So stories, what are the in the public folder which is there, that can be only deployed to other things. There are some audit logs as well which is useful to trace the logs of the particular files. So whenever we wanted to see different logs of a particular deployment things which we are doing, that kind of logs will be stored in these log files. Then lastly, we can see system usages, which type of which model is taking more time, or which has taken more usage or memory of this. That can be displayed in the screen, where you can see some of the models has more memory, like you can say 17 MB or something. Some of the very slow, small, and that can be displayed it here. Some of them are very small. It is useful for the performance perspective, where we can see which model is taking more memory when we wanted to improve the performance of the system. That's it from this video. I hope you have understood this. If you have any questions, then please put it in comment section. If you like my video, then please like it and subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you for watching.